goodbye, my Redbridge Rose. Hey. Now there's a man who liked to do his business in the middle of the park.
Yeah. Retired in his prime, Pete. Yeah. That overtight army got the better of him in the end, eh?
A phenomenal footballer.
Oh.
Remember that night in the cup at Spennymoor? Oh.
Ooh.
We were outpassed and outclassed for most of that game, yeah. And then Nolan decided to attempt what everybody else believed to be mission impossible.
Yeah, that's my favourite film, that.
Three goals down with only 10 minutes to play, and somehow he clawed us back to 3-3.
Then in the return at ours, we got battered 5-0. He had an absolute shocker.
He's only just bloody retired, mate. Show him some respect.
One Mickey Nolan. There's only one Mickey Nolan.
One Mickey Nolan. There's only one Mickey Nolan.
One Mickey Nolan. There's only one Mickey Nolan. One Mickey Nolan.
Are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
I can see you now.
Gillian's cat's gone missing.
No.
Yes. It's a blue cat called Johnson. It's got a very spunky attitude, Marilyn.
You broke up then, sis? All I heard was spunky.
Gillian's missing blue cat.
Are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
Oh, I can see you now.
Gillian's missing...
Are you
missing...
here?
Yes, I'm here. Oh. Your face has stopped moving.
God save the gracious queen, long live our noble queen. God save the queen,
da-da-da-da,
send a victorious, happy and glorious, long to
Willie went missing after the charity night on Saturday, didn't you? I woke up in the night, went into his room, felt along his duvet, and he wasn't there. I phoned the police, and all they said was, he's 47, and he's only been missing for an hour and a quarter.
I went for some fresh air because of my deviated septum.
You know the rules. When you leave the house while I'm sleeping, you inform me by ringing the night bell.
Ringing the night
bell?
She's
got a night bell.
Night bell?
What about the time you spat on that hot light bulb?
Which exploded in my face. I still don't know why I did that.
Marilyn was crackers when we were growing up, Sam.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were. You used to eat your own bed linen.
Oh, yes, yeah, so I did.
And she was absolutely obsessed with animal muck. Oh, she's frozen over again.
When did she move to New Zealand?
25 years ago. All for a man who was big in women's clothes. Oh, well, he soon buggered off.
I'm back with Bonks.
Is that good?
Yeah. He said he'd only shag the girls from Betfred because he was stressed about having a baby and Liam will have his own bedroom.
There are loads of dog shits in Holland.
Hey, Tom. You'll never believe what Tom did to me in the van yesterday. He only woke me up to read me some of his poetry.
You're taking my todger, eh?
No, honestly. I mean, I just think, if you're going to write poetry, you've got to keep it to yourself, and that's just the way it is.
Oh, yeah. No, he's right there, Ten Peg. Pete wrote a few poems when you were at school, didn't you, Pete? Eh?
Not a lot.
Not a lot, no, but you wrote a few, didn't you? Yeah. And then the rest of the lads found out, and they pissed in a school bag.
All right. Meryl is here to watch the England game, everyone.
Look at the state of that.
Here's big Mandy Carter.
Hello, Mandy.
And over here are the Dunbrows.
We're 12 hours behind Auckland, so it's a good morning from the UK.
Who do you think you are?
Here's two of the Gunderson triplets, Lee and Bruce.
Oh, hello.
And here's the lovely Tom Capstick.
Hello, Tom.
Right.
Now, where would you like me to put you?
Where's Peter sitting?
He's over here, Marilyn.
You're in, Mott.
Shut up, you long-haired gonad.
There you go.
Hey, Ma, there must be an easier way for you to watch the game than this, love.
Oh, I like the company. I can't see Pete.
He's behind you.
Oh, yes, that's better.
Macedonia have just kicked off.
Oh, tilt me round.
Mom. Just to let you know, due to the television stations using a compression software, your radio commentary is about 20 seconds ahead of us.
Macedonia have just got their first free kick.
Oh, we can't. I haven't even kicked off yet. Yeah.
Stupid old cow.
Hey, tell I'm going to phone old Niblock's footy phoning show later, give him the bad news about Nolan retiring.
What's that, Mott? You're going to make a cock of yourself on the radio again?
Hey, have you two ever wondered what life would have been like if you hadn't have been starved of oxygen at birth?
Oh, yeah, if we were starved of oxygen, how come we're buying a Subaru?
You can't afford a Subaru.
Watch this space, Mott.
Stop arguing, Peter.
What about Neptune?
I mean,
Hey, kick off.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hey,
hi, babe.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Mel wants to get into football. Did he, babe?
Yeah, my sorry.
Now, what's different about you, Melvin?
Dean from Harry Poppins has threaded my eyebrows.
My Leonard had one long, thick eyebrow, virtually from ear to ear. I worried that I'd never be able to see past it, but in the end, it was the thing I loved about him most. Oh, Melvin, you won't know, will you? Gillian's blue cat's gone missing.
There's no such thing as a blue cat.
Well, there is, Francis, because I've seen Johnson and he's a British blue.
Is it actually blue, Dor?
No, grey.
Well, then you're a ridiculous woman.
Bloody hell. I'd love a cat.
I want a lizard.
You've already got one.
Not a lizard.
I think it's mental you're not allowed to keep big cats anymore.
Come on.
If you've got the proper caging, why not?
I'm with you, Mans.
You thought about getting a guide dog, Trevor?
I don't need one, thank you. I've got my Willy.
Come on, lads, bloody hell. This is all shit.
Is there double Dennis's pizza then? Yes, I would like one large mighty meaty with the medium crazy cheesy bread. Yeah, mighty meaty, mighty meaty, mighty meaty, mighty meaty, mighty meaty, yes, mighty meaty.
Sorry, Mans.
It's all right, I'm done.
Started wearing knickers.
Can I have a word, Dor?
Yeah, of course.
I started saying Willy.
Willy? Willy, Willy?
Yeah.
Oh?
He came back to mine last Saturday after the charity night and we shagged for the first time.
Oh?
No one can know, Dor, do you understand?
Of course.
The thing is, I don't know if I'm being out of order here, but he was proper turd.
Oh, no. Go on, what happened?
Look, I love this club door, you know that, but I'm lying there in the nip, all revved up like you wouldn't believe. And he's wittering on about our chances of avoiding relegation. Oh. And that's no way to give big mans a bomb, though.
No. How much do you like Willie?
Oh, loads. He's a lovely man. I haven't had many of those in my life.
I think you're just going to have to be patient with him. You know, it'll be worth it in the end. Trust me.
Cheers, Dor.
Is somebody there?
Yes, Francis. It's Doreen and Mandy.
I thought I was all alone. By the way, I'm not fond of your new air fresheners. Why would you want the place to smell like you're having a dump in Honolulu?
What was that?
When Mike Nolan was at his best, he'd just open his legs and something exciting had happened.
Right. What colour do England dress in?
Playing, babe. White.
Thank you.
Gary Lineker doesn't play for England anymore, does he?
No.
Oh, I liked him.
Yeah, he's a lovely colour.
I'm a quarter Swiss door.
Oh.
It was Maltese last week.
He's both. His name's from Basel.
Yeah, and I've got some Chad in me. Mm.
Hey, do you hear where that player from Basel FC came out last season? Right? Aye, aye, yeah.
Well, I bet most teams have a gay player, don't they, Terence?
Do I?
Redbridge haven't.
How do you know?
Well, you do the maths. Without Kieran Tarbuck's gay, he works at Sports Direct. Trevor McCready does taekwondo. Nolan's got a wife and a kid.
Well, I had a wife and I got kids. I'm gay.
Yeah, but you didn't know you were gay.
Yeah, I did. I just didn't come out.
Okay. I'm just saying. I'm not bothered either way.
Any one of them could be a gay player.
I don't even know why we're having this conversation.
Maybe Gary Woodburn, Pete.
You cannot tell me Gary Woodburn's gay. Not with that throw on.
This is not a large, mighty, meaty. I ordered a large, mighty, meaty pizza with medium, crazy, cheesy bread. And you got me a medium, mighty, meaty with the large, crazy, cheesy bread.
Oh, I expect you're out looking for Johnson. It's just a quick message. I've looked under all the cars on North Cuddam Lane and the Lagoon Estate, and I had a quick scoot around Reedham Park for about 40 minutes. And Delia Wise said she put up a poster in her lounge window.
She lives at the top of the flats, don't she?
And just to say, if there's anything you need me to do, just give me a quick tinkle. Oh, I'll have to go before I start annoying everybody because we're watching an England football game. And just to say that if there is anything you need me to do, give me a quick tinkle. Yeah. And in the meantime, I will print out another batch of those posters. All right, then. Bye.
Any chance of getting a copy of that message, Dor? Only I'm having trouble sleeping.
Oh, shut up, Peter.
Me?
Your trousers look nice and tight, Peter.
Well, they're not.
Nice yellows.
Bloody shite, England. Look at you, Welsh. Mel coming to all the games now, then.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? He's making a real effort.
Yeah. I just worry you're getting too serious too quick, though, you know.
No, I'm happy, you know. I'm not interested in playing the field. I don't want to shag other guys.
I'm not saying that, mate, no.
I mean, I get your concerns, you know, I can see where you're coming from. I know I've only been with one bloke, but... Well.
Well, what? Eh? Come on, you can't just do that. What were you going to say?
Huh? Nothing.
Come on, tell.
Remember your 18th birthday party you had in that barn?
Yeah.
Remember Ian Palsy, that young gymnast lad?
It bothers me. What about him?
Use your noodle, Pete.
Well, Ian Palsy's a postman.
Oh, yeah, I wrote a poem yesterday, but Pete says that you shouldn't read other people your poems, and that's just the way it is.
Can I hear it?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. A is for Akin Bowie, who played under 21s for Gambia. He's so quick and so fast, but still works at the Multiplex Cinema in Macclesfield. B is for Bruce, whose brother is Lee, who claims disability allowance for a bad back, but Pete says that that's all bollocks. C is Redbridge Cricket Club.
Told you I could do it. Take it back, bro.
But Pete thinks it's a game for wankers. D is for the Dumbrells, Norman, Willie and Francis. They used to go to boot sales wearing matching sailor suits. E is for
right.
Energy.
Yeah, you.
Drinks, which
yeah.
Tell was addicted to...
Worried about Nolan, you?
Yeah.
Why do you think I'm a lizard?
Oh, shite. Well, I don't understand this. You can get over a hamstring injury. I mean, Nolan's earning, what, 120 quid a game? That's twice as much as anyone else. I mean, why would you want to throw that away? What's he going to do now?
He's doing a hairdressing course.
Exactly. He's doing a what?
Mike's doing an adult education hairdressing course.
A what?
He's doing a hairdressing course in the evening, and then him and Luca are being Saturday boys at Harry Poppins. Mike did mention he could have stayed on for Redbridge, but apparently thought, what's the point? They're going down anyway.
That is an absolute whiz with the scissors.
Oh, yeah, no, by all accounts, he's taken to it like a duck to water door. Dean said he grabs hold of your hair like it's a £50 note.
Well, I don't think we need him.
What's that mean?
Nolan, I don't think this team needs him. Like we said, we've got a load of good youngsters. Let's start playing them.
You change your tune, you knob.
No, I haven't. If Nolan wants to go off and be a hairdresser, that's his choice. I mean, I wouldn't do it, but there you go. Anyway, Nolan's the past. We've got to look to the future.
Are you off now?
Phoning Niblock's phoning show.
Trev, bung Nibber's show and Mott's going to make a cock of himself again.
I'm sorry, what was that? All I heard was blah, 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 I'm a sphincter.
R is for Ramsbottom United, where Pete got overexcited. He ran on the pitch and got escorted away, and now he's not allowed back on the ground for 3 years.
Poor Pete.
Yeah. And what annoyed him more than anything was that everyone said they were going to run on the pitch with him, but they didn't. They just, like, sat there, like, laughing at him. Bad. S is for Sam. Yeah. Who I've fallen in love with. T is for Tarpaulin.
I'm back with Bonks.
Oh, everyone! Gillian and Roy have found their blue cat. Oh. One of those abseiling window cleaners saw the poster in Delia Wyatt's lounge.
Turn the football down. Lots on the radio.
OK, Pete, you're talking to the goal mouth, Owen Niblock. What do you want to say, mate?
All right, Nibbers, you legend.
Yeah. What's your point?
Oh, right.
2 points I want to make. Mike Nolan.
Yeah, what about him?
Yeah, he played for Redbridge for 6 seasons. But now he's retired and...
he's left a big hole. I didn't realise how great he was until now.
Oh, really? You're missing him, clearly.
Oh, God.
Are you there, Pete?
Yeah. I want to look to the future, but...
I can't. I want to rely on the youngsters, but
We'll go down. I don't want to go down.
Okay, well, obviously Peter's getting a little emotional. Dear Lord, seems like a good time to play a tune. We'll take another call after.
Trousers do look very tight, Peter.
Well, they're not.